Wood to the vault. Currently, after rotation number one, Florida takes the lead, 49.4 after their rotation on the bars. Nebraska put up a 49.225 on the vault, which matches a season best that they also scored last week as a team. Eastern Michigan, 48.025 on the beam, and Lindenwood, 49.025 on the floor. So as Nebraska moves over to the bars, what are some of the things that the judges will be looking for here to score this competition?
So over on the bars, it's important to have a single bar release as well as a high bar to the low bar release move or transition skill. Definitely looking for handstands, hitting all of your handstands and having good form throughout the entire routine and sticking the landing to minimize your deductions.
So the bars last week, Nebraska matched a season best 49.425. Had a couple of Huskers match or earn a career high on this event. Florida on the beam last week tied, was the second highest team score, the 49.575. They're ranked third in the nation on the beam. So we are about to see some excellent gymnastics over here on the beam as well. Lindenwood over on the vault will be led off by Leah Parton. Chenge Bakshwe will be in the leadoff spot for the Husker. Skylar Drazer leading things off for Florida on the beam. Ella Shamadi will lead things off for Eastern Michigan on the floor.
For the second rotation.
You were saying lots of energy in this building. It got pretty loud there in rotation number one.
It did, and it's great to see all of the athletes, too, cheering on their teammates while they're going.
So Chenge Bakshwe, the sophomore out of Hungary, again, as we've talked a lot about this season, has qualified for the Olympics for her home country of Hungary on the vault. She's competing in the all-around for the first time in her career this season and has done a really great job for the Huskers this season and leading things off here on the uneven bars.
Here's that transition back up to the high bar. Chenge just has the dismount left. It'll be a double layout. Small step on the landing, but overall a good routine to get things going for Nebraska.
And leading things off on the vault, this is a look at Leah Parton for Lindenwood. And on the beam for the Gators, Skylar Drazer, freshman out of South Huntington, New York.
Starting off with the series, backhand spring layout, very solid on that.
Coming off a 9.85 last week.
And that leadoff spot is so important. It can help set the tone for the rest of the lineup, give them some confidence going into their routines as well. And just the dismount, round off 1.5, finds the landing, gets the stick.
It's a way to start. Skylar Drazer again leading things off for the Gators. Back over on vault, this is Jaylee Jones for Lindenwood.
Back over on the bars, this is Whitney Jinks for Nebraska. Beautiful release move. It's a combination that she does down to the low bar.
Freshman coming off a career-high 9.9 last week.
This has been a great routine so far. Just the dismount. Double layout. Stuck landing.
Great job by the freshman. She follows up Chenge back, she plays 9-7-5.
Whitney's been very consistent throughout this season. Great to see as a freshman.
Back over on the vault, this is Hannah Applegate for Lindenwood. And on the beam, here is Ellie Lazari, the senior out of Wheaton, Illinois, for the Gators.
Going for a series. That was a triple series by Can Spring layout. It's incredibly difficult to do. You don't see that quite as often.
Skylar Drazer led things off with a 9-9 for the Gators.
Ellie's really finding her rhythm during this routine. Nice and confident throughout each skill. Dismount, cartwheel gainer full off the end. Another solid routine for the Gators on beam.
Huge vault over here for Lindenwood by Reese Backley.
Stuck Yurchenko full.
Back over to the bars. This is Clara Colombo, one of the seniors that'll be honored here tonight.
Clara's getting ready for the dismount. The double tuck finds the landing.
That was one of the best routines I've seen from her this season.
That was a great routine. She looks to be very happy with that one.
Her last time competing here inside the Devaney Center as a Husker. Next up on the beam for the Gators, Morgan Hurd, junior out of Middleton, Delaware.
Front aerial to a back handspring. You can see right from the get-go that Morgan is very sharp with her movements. Dismount, round off, double twist. Good routine from Morgan Hurd.
Back over to the bars, Emma Simpton coming off career high 9-9 last week.
Just the dismount left for this routine. Double layout, a little pike down on that last flip, but found the landing.
Back over to the beam, Anya Pilgrim. Coming off a 9.95 last week. Season high is a 9.975. Reese Backley for Lindenwood put up a 9-9 on the vault. That's a career high for her. Big score for Lindenwood. They have completed their rotation.
Anya's starting off the routine. Going in for a series, backhand spring layout step out. No wobble on that there.
See the scores in for Morgan Hurd, a 9-7. Following up Ellie Lazari's 9-9.
Anya appears to be very calm during this routine, taking it one skill at a time. Leap combination, a switch leap to a leap out of it. Backhand spring gainer full, stuck landing.
Nicely done. Here's a look at Emma Spence on the uneven bars. Couple of scores to pass along for the Huskers. Emma Simpton had a 9-8. Whitney Jenks a 9-8-5. Clara Colombo matches a season high 9-8-7-5. See Lindenwood. They have completed their vault rotation. 48-9-7-5. Kinsey Davis is just about set to perform her final bars routine as a Husker inside this building, inside the Devaney Center. She's on another one of those seniors honored on Senior Day. Scores in for Emma Spence, a 9-9.
Kinsey's doing a beautiful job during this routine. She is an amazing bar worker. She hits that last handstand on the high bar. And just the dismount left, a double layout. Small hop on the landing, but a great routine from the senior, Kinsey Davis.
And a huge reception there from her teammates. Back over on the beam for the Gators. Victoria Wynn.
Victoria's a beautiful beam worker. The dismount left in this routine. Backhand spring back 1.5.
And this is Genesis Gibson in an exhibition routine for Nebraska. Pair of 9-9s to close things out for Nebraska on the uneven bars. 9-9 from Emma Spence and a 9-9 from Kinsey Davis.
A strong exhibition routine from Genesis Gibson there.
So Nebraska as a team finishes with a 49-3-2-5 on the bars rotation. Eastern Michigan is performing on the floor. This is Anna Grace McCullough.
First tumbling pass. Thank you. very expressive during this floor routine. Front layout to a Rudy, which is a 1.5.
So look at Leanne Wong on the beam. The anchor spot for the Gators. Didn't see the end of that routine, but had an uncharacteristic fall on her dismount.
It looked like she missed the end of the beam with at least 1 foot, possibly kind of slipped with 2 feet.
She did hop up pretty quickly, looked to be okay. Victoria Wynn had a 9.95, which ties her career high just before Wong. Back over on the floor for Eastern Michigan, this is Raisa Boris. Off her sixth consecutive all-around win, seventh of the season. Her career high in the all-around last week. 9-9 on this event last week. She is the reigning MAC gymnast of the week.
Looks like Raisa is doing a 3-pass floor routine. Going in for the last tumbling pass, a double tuck. Step forward out of that. You want to see the athlete step backwards if they're doing a backwards tumbling pass.
So that was the final competitor. The lineup for Eastern Michigan on the floor. An exhibition routine for Florida on the beam, Melissa Arana.
Good leap combination. That was a switch leap to a switch half. Solid full turn. Gainer full dismount off the side. Good exhibition routine for Florida.
And we will close things out in this exhibition with this exhibition routine for Eastern Michigan. This is Priya Carley.
First tumbling pass, punch 1.5, layout step out to a straddle jump. Combination there, did a great job at that.
It's fun music.
It is. I love how Eastern Michigan has really been showing off their facial expressions during their floor routines. Definitely helps keep the crowd engaged.
Grace had a 9.8 prior to this exhibition routine.
Front layout to front full.
So that closes out rotation number two. The final score was in for Florida on the beam. Leanne Wong had an 8-9-2-5, so the Gators finished with a 49-3-2-5 in that rotation. Nebraska, the 49-3-2-5. Linden went on the vault, the 48-9-7-5, and Eastern Michigan with the 48-8-5. So you can see the team scores there on the graphic. 98.725 for Florida. Nebraska with a 98.550. Linden with the 98 even. And so for Nebraska on the beam, they'll be led off by the freshman Isabel Sycon, coming off a career high 9.875 last week. And in fact, Nebraska as a team put up a season high 49.3 on the beam. Let's look at Isabel. She gets warmed up. Calm, cool, and collected. That's how head coach Heather Brink refers to her, which is what you want in this leadoff spot.
Definitely, and it's great to see that a freshman is leading off. That's sometimes a little bit unusual. You want somebody that can go up and be very solid and consistent. Isabel does just that. Excited to see that here during this routine. We'll start with a series. Backhand spring layout, step out. A little bit of a wobble on that skill. So a wobble like that could be anywhere from a tenth to about a tenth and a half of a deduction, typically. Switch half for a leap. Should just have the dismount left. Okay, back handspring, back one and a half, stuck landing. Overall, a good routine to start off the beam rotation for Nebraska.
This is Reese Backley leading things off for Lindenwood on the uneven bars. Coming off a career high 9.85 on this event last week. And over on the vault, this was Jackie Patterson led things off. That was wrong. I believe that was Janae Daniel for Eastern Michigan. Lori Brubach was leadoff for Florida Gators on the floor. And up next for Nebraska, Bialy Gard on the beam.
Getting some words of encouragement from Coach Heather Brink before Allie goes.
Allie Gard.
Going in for a series, backhand spring layout, step out. Looks like she pulled her arms up just a little too soon on that series, which resulted in a slight wobble. Full turn. I love how she stayed on releve throughout that whole skill. Yeah. combination of skills for Allie on beam. She hit a very good connection, kept a great rhythm throughout that. Just a dismount. Gainer Pike, stuck dismount. Another hit routine for Nebraska.
Ray Saboris on the vault for Eastern Michigan.
And that was a unique vault.
And Lyndon Wood on the bars. This is Jaylee Jones. This is Hannah Moon for Lyndon Wood. Up next for Nebraska on the beam, see Change Bakshwe having a final chat with head coach Heather Brink. Hannah Moon set to mount the bars here for Lyndon Wood.
Transition from the low bar up to the high bar, back down. Going in for the dismount, double layout, stuck landing. That was a gorgeous routine. Very few deductions throughout that.
Back over to the beam, Change Bakshwe.
Triple series to start off the routine. Switch leap to a split jump that fulfills the dance requirement for beam. Chingay is looking very confident throughout this routine. So far, she should just have the dismount left. Round off double twist, stuck landing. Huskers great. Are doing a great job at finding those landings over on the beam.
Great reaction from the crowd and our teammates. Back over to the vault, Alana Fisher for Eastern Michigan. Naya Krause now on the bars for Lyndon Wood.
Gorgeous combination release move there. She had great amplitude on that first one. The dismount, a full in. Hop back on the landing, but a solid routine for Lyndon Wood.
For Nebraska, Isabel Sykon led things off with a 9.775. Allie Gard had a 9.825. We await Change Bakshwe's score. Up next on the beam for the Huskers will be Asia Hall. A couple of scores for Florida. Lori Brubach led things off with a 9.825. Victoria Wynn had a 9.875. Eastern Michigan's rotation on the vault is complete. 47.975. We await one final score for Eastern Michigan. Here is Asia Hall on the beam before the Huskers.
Asia starts off with a back handspring layout, step out. Quite follow through with that, it looked like. Able to hold on to it and not fall off the beam though, which is good. Front aerial, getting things back on track. Jump combination, just a slight wobble on that. Out and round. round off 1.5.
Here's Kaylee Cooper for Lyndon Wood back over on the bars.
Starting off good, handstand on the high bar. Going into a Pike Jaeger to an immediate overshoot. Just the dismount. Double layout. It's a solid routine for Kaylee Cooper on the bars.
Morgan Hurd just finished up for the Gators on the floor so far. Lori Brubach at a 9.825. Victoria Wynn a 9.875. Kaylee Bluffstone a 9.85. Next up on the beam for Nebraska will be Emma Spence. Asia Hall a 9.55 for Nebraska, so the look to drop that score.
Starting off with a single wolf turn. Those are incredibly difficult to do on the beam. Front aerial into back handspring. So another triple series with that. Switch leap to a split jump. Emma Spence has looked very confident throughout this routine. Just the dismount left. Round off back 1.5. Looks to be very happy with that, getting all of the hugs and high fives from her team now.
Back over to the bars, Hannah Applegate for Lindenwood. She gets set to mount the bars. Skylar Drazer is competing on the floor right now for Florida.
Hannah's in that anchor spot. It looks like they did have a fall early on in the lineup. So this could be a crucial routine to hopefully build on that team score a little bit.
Yeah, it was the first routine to go for Lindenwood, so far everybody has done their job.
And Ginga release move down to an overshoot. A little close on the bar on the overshoot. Just the dismount. Double layout. Finds the landing, so that will be definitely able to use that score in order to, you know, drop the other one.
Here is Sophia McClellan in the anchor spot for Nebraska on the beam.
Sophia, another beautiful beam worker, starts off with a double wolf turn.
Up Emma Spence's 9.85.
Jump combination. So we had to take her eyes off the beam during that, which is difficult when you're flipping on a 4-inch balance beam. And just a dismount. Backhand swing, back 1.5, small hop, but a made routine, which is great to see.
Over on the floor competing for Florida is Anya Pilgrim, a freshman coming off her first collegiate career 10, but we're watching an exhibition routine here from Lindenwood. Celebration there for Anya Pilgrim as we await the final score there from Florida. Exhibition routine for Nebraska over on the beam will be Whitney Jinks.
Going in for a series, backhand swing layout, step out. Gorgeous full turn. You could see she's on high releve during that. Front toss, very solid so far. Bobble on that leap series. The dismount, back 1.5. Surprised to find the landing, but that was a good exhibition routine for Whitney Jinks.
And Danny Ferris competing in an exhibition routine for Florida on the floor. Anya Pilgrim scores in a 9.775, so 49.225 for the Gators on that rotation.
These are going to be some of the last few meets that teams can have athletes exhibition once you move into those postseason meets. There's no longer that option, so can see a lot of teams taking advantage of that tonight.
The Gator Chunk. So that closes the books on rotation number 3. Lindenwood over on the uneven bars put up a big score, 49-225. Florida on the floor, 49-225. Nebraska on the beam, a 49.15. And Eastern Michigan on the vault, a 48.4. So you see the overall meet status. Florida leading the way with a 148.175. Nebraska with a 147.7. Lindenwood, 147.225. And Eastern Michigan, 145.275. All right, we're back with the fourth and final rotation here inside the Devaney Center in Lincoln, Nebraska, coming up here on Big Ten Plus. Harris is set to lead things off for Eastern Michigan on the bars. Here is Whitney Jinks, freshman out of Madison, South Dakota.
First tumbling pass is a combination and a good control on the landing. For the leap pass, the judges are looking to see that the athlete hits 180 degree split in the air. Tumbling pass, back double tuck. She spots the floor as she's about to land.
Great start for the Huskers from Whitney Jakes. This is Skylar Drazer to lead things off for the Gators. Huge vault here. Hannah Moon on the beam for Lindenwood. It's a 9-9 for Skylar Drazer.
Dismount over on beam. Gainer full off the end, off the side of the beam.
This is Molly Paris on the bars for Eastern Michigan. Look at her dismount.
Double layout, chest down just a little bit, but she covers it well.
It's Victoria Wynn on the vault for the Gators.
This will be a Yurchenko 1.5, 10-0 start value. Great vault over there. The whole team looks to be very excited.
Pair of 9-9s to start things for the Gators from Skylar Drazer and Ellie Lazari. .985 for Whitney Jinks to lead things off for the Huskers. Hallie Rourke is on the floor now for Nebraska. The hometown Husker out of Waverly, Nebraska. It's a great performer.
Hallie does a two-pass floor routine. Her first tumbling pass looked really good. Just has to hit the last pass. Double pipe. So two good tumbling passes in that routine.
Great job by Hallie Rourke. This is Jaden Kosu for Lindenwood on the beam. Had some huge scores for Florida on the vault. Victoria Wynn had a 9.925. Just saw another big vault from Anya Pilgrim.
Gainer full dismount, stuck landing for Lindenwood on the beam.
Hannah Moon led things off for Lindenwood with the 9.825. Florida on the vault is Danny Ferris.
We've seen those 10-0 start values from Florida on the vault.
Eastern Michigan over on the bars. Here's Chenge Bakshwe on the floor for Nebraska. Posted career highs on every event this season.
Super powerful first tumbling pass. That was a back 2.5 to front tuck.
Music is so distinctive.
There. She hit that 180 degrees in the air. Going in for another tumbling pass, back double pike. It's a great height on that tumbling pass. She landed with her chest up, all very good things.
Eastern Michigan on the uneven bars. That was Jaylee Jones, her dismount off the beam for Lyndon Wood. Florida has completed their vault lineup, highlighted by a 995 from Anya Pilgrim. This is Bree Edwards in an exhibition vault.
Powerful Yurchenko full. A little hop back on the landing. She had great amplitude off the table.
Jordan Jankowski. Score is in for Eastern Michigan is a 9-8. This is Kyrie Lau.
Salto down to the low bar. And dismount, slight hop on that. Made routine. Great routine for Eastern Michigan.
Martina Gomeen, the senior, is performing over on the floor for Nebraska. Her final routine for the Huskers here inside the Devaney Center. Madison Rush for Lyndon Wood on the beam. We have a fall over there on the beam. Florida's vault rotation is complete. 49-5-2-5 for the Gators. Madison Rush completes her beam routine and over on the bars for Eastern Michigan. Kyrie Lau and Raisa Boris closing things out for Eastern Michigan on the bars. Martina Comeen, a 9.875 for the Huskers on the floor in her final routine, getting some big hugs as the senior, celebrating senior day. Holly Rourke had a 9.875. Chenge Bakshwe also with a 9.875. Hannah Applegate set to mount the beam for Lyndon Wood. This is an exhibition routine for Eastern Michigan. On the floor, Sophia McClellan is anchoring things for Nebraska.
Started off her routine with a punch front double.
She is not the anchor. Emma Spence is the anchor. This is Sophia McClellan, though. Great performer. Loves to perform.
Those are gorgeous leaps. Hitting oversplit on all of those. Going into her final tumble pass. Great job on that. Good control.
Big smiles there. Great routine from Sophia McClellan for the Huskers. And Nebraska is pumped. Hannah Applegate on the dismount off the beam for Lyndon Wood. Martina Comeen had a 9.775. We'll await Sophia McClellan's score. Emma Spence will anchor things for the Huskers on the floor. Eastern Michigan has completed their rotation. .48325 for Eastern Michigan over on the bars. Nia Kraus set to anchor things for Lindenwood on the beam. Here is Emma Spence to close things out for the Huskers over on the floor. Had a 9.9 last week.
Emma is a great performer on floor.
9.9 is the score for Sophia.
Going in first tumbling pass, front tuck through the double back, spots the ground. Great landing. So it was a switch ring to a split full. Final tumbling pass, a double pipe. Another solid landing there.
What a way to finish for the Huskers on senior night, on the final home meet of the season. Emma Spence, huge reaction, great reaction from her teammates. Colin Fortin. Great rotation for the Huskers there on the floor. Emma getting some more hugs from the teammates. Big score coming in for Emma. .995 looks like, which would be a season high and a career high. .995 for Emma Spence, a career high for her on the floor. This is Allie Gard in an exhibition routine to close things out.
Opened with a double pike. Good landing on that first tumbling pass. Front layout to front full. Just a little too much power on that front full. Does a three pass, three tumbling passes in her routine. So this will be the final tumbling pass. Double tuck.
And that is Allie Gard, an exhibition routine for Nebraska. The Huskers put up a 49-4-5-0 on the floor, which matches a season high, highlighted by a career high 995 from Emma Spence. The Huskers also the career high or a season high 197.15. Looks to be the best score of the season for the Huskers.
Great to see. I'm glad that they're able to go out there and continue to build from last week.
This is a final look at the exhibition routine from Leah Pardon on the beam for Lindenwood. They had a great rotation on the beam, a 49-1. The balance beam to close things out. And a grid meet for Lindenwood. So final scores this evening. Florida wins it 197.7. Nebraska with a season high 197.15. Lindenwood 196.325, and Eastern Michigan with a 193.6. Individual awards from the meet and the team awards, so keep it here on Big Ten Plus. Welcome back inside the Devaney Center in Lincoln, Nebraska. The seniors of every team were just honored with some flowers. That's always neat, especially when you're on the road as the season is winding down, your career is winding down, to be recognized even in your not home gym.
Yeah, I think it's great to show support for all of those seniors. They've worked so hard to get to this point, and it's great to honor them for these last couple meets throughout the season.
For Nebraska, they send out their seniors at a high note. How much is that a goal when you go into it, is wanting to perform really well for your seniors in their final time inside the Devaney Center?
Yeah, it can be a little bit of extra pressure. I think that, you know, you always want to go out with a hit routine and go out doing your best. But I think that all of the seniors out here tonight did a great job doing that. And we'll definitely remember their last time competing inside the Devaney Center.
Again, the final team scores of the night. Florida 197-7. Nebraska with the season high 197-15. Lindenwood 196-325. Eastern Michigan 193-6. Should mention, we'd had an all-around graphic earlier. Emma Spence, the 39-5-5. That is a season high for her. She finished second in the all-around competition. We're getting set to hand out those individual awards. Winners on each event here tonight. We appreciate Emeritus, tonight's sponsor, and Emeritus is a proud sponsor of all of Husker women's athletics. Great sponsor here at Nebraska. Anya Pilgrim, your vault champion there at the 995. Outstanding freshman. Looking at one of the top freshmen in the country, Anya Pilgrim.
Going back to third. In a three-way tie for third place. All with a score of 9.9. First, from Lindenwood, Reese Beckley.
So handing out more than just the overall champion. So there's Kinsey Davis on senior night, the tie for third.
And from Nebraska, Emma Spence.
Emma Spence there, sharing that title with her. For Leanne Wong as she takes the bars title.
Now your champions on me.
in a two-way tie for third place, both with a score of 9-9. First, from Florida, Ellie Lazari.
Gators sweep this one. Ellie Lazari, Skylar Drazer tying for third. Leanne Wong will take second with a 9.925.
Second with a score of 9.925 from Florida, Leanne Wong. And your champion on beam with a score of 9.95 from Florida,
there is Victoria Wynn, your champion on the beam.
Now your champions on floor in a three-way tie for third place, Hall with a score of 9.875. First from Nebraska, Hallie Rorick.
Lots of Huskers going to be honored here in this event. Tie for third, Hallie Rourke, Jenge Bakshway of Nebraska, and Victoria Wynn of Florida, 9.875. Sophia McClellan takes second, 9.9. And a career high for Emma Spence on the floor with a 9.95. Gives her the title on floor. Season high for Emma in the all-around competition.
And your champion in the all-around with a score of 39.625 from Florida, Victoria Wynn.
And there's your all-around champion, Victoria Wynn of Florida with a 39.625. So that will do it for us. Well, after we hand out the team awards. But before we sign off here again, we're going to have senior night celebration. And you talk about Martina Comeen, Clara Columba, and Kenzie Davis all being honored tonight. What have those three meant to this Nebraska women's gymnastics program?
They have definitely all been true leaders on the team, kind of helping the rest of that team find their way throughout every single season. And it's been great to see them go out and hit all of the events that they do and also just contribute to the program aside from their gymnastics. They're all, you know, it's tough to be a student athlete, so doing every single thing inside and out of the gym, being leaders in and out of the gym.
So announcing the team awards, again, Florida is your winner here tonight, but Nebraska puts up another big team score as they continue to build in terms of confidence and moving towards the end of the season. How important is that as this team continues to put together their best performances?
Yeah, I think that it's definitely important to continue to build, and I think that they're showing that here tonight and moving forward, using that confidence from today and hopefully continuing with that throughout the season.
All right, final thoughts?
I thought that there was a lot of great gymnastics tonight from all four teams. There was a lot of season highs, some career highs, and good team scores. So, a great showing tonight. Solid performance from all four teams.
We'll look forward to the end of the season coming up as all these teams head towards their conference and then the postseason conference championships and then their postseason as well. Up next for Nebraska, they'll be at Arkansas for the final regular season meet coming up Friday, March 15th. And then 2 weeks from tonight, they'll head to the Big Ten championships starting March 23rd. All right, thanks so much for watching and listening all season long here on our coverage of Nebraska gymnastics here on Big Ten Plus. For my partner, Kenzie Roby, and our great Husker Vision crew, thanks for watching and have a great night.